This is a hearing into the matter of Private Desmond Doss. The charge is disobeying a series of direct orders from his commanding officer. How says the defendant?
Private Doss wishes to enter a not guilty plea.
Is that so, Private? I thought this was agreed. You wanted to enter some sort of plea bargain.
Yes, sir, but I changed my mind.
Just like that. You wish to proceed to a court-martial.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Well, on your head then, Private. Proceed.
Your Honor, Private Doss waves his morality at us like it's some kind of badge of honor. He flaunts his contempt by directly disobeying a series of direct orders from his commanding officer, when the very best of our young men are sacrificing their lives against...
You okay?
Yes.
Are they still deliberating?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now you go take this in there.
I can't. Strictly military personnel.
Well, then you get one of them to take it in.
They ain't out to help. They're fixing to bury him.
There is only one question that any military court need ask of the accused. Do you deny disobeying Colonel Sangston's direct orders?
Well, do you, Private?
No, sir, I don't.
Why are you contesting it, then? Why is it so important to you, given your refusal to even touch a weapon, to serve in a combat unit?
Because when the Japanese attacked Pearl Harbor, I took it personal. Everyone I knew was on fire to join up, including me. There were two men in my hometown. Declared 4F unfit, they killed themselves because they couldn't serve. I had a job in a defense plant. I could have taken a deferment, but that ain't right. It isn't right that other men should fight and die, that I would just be sitting at home safe. I need to serve. I got the energy and the passion to serve as a medic. Right in the middle with the other guys, no less danger, just... while everybody else is taking life, I'm gonna be saving it. With the world so set on tearing itself apart, it doesn't seem like such a bad thing to me to want to put a little bit of it back together.
Sorry, sir. Nobody's allowed to go.
No, you don't understand. My son is the defendant.
I understand, sir, but nobody's allowed to
go. I have information.
While the sentiments expressed are laudable, the facts of the charge seem incontestable, so... what the hell is going on out there? Let him go. That's a great war uniform.
It is, sir. Sir, I need to show you this.
With respect, sir, you are no longer a member of the military. You are unable to attend this hearing. I'm sorry.
Is that truly the way it works, sir? You fight for your country, you lose so much that was dear to you, and then you're done with? The uniform's forgotten. You have no voice.
You were at least.
I was Sir Annabella Wood.
Twice decorated, I see.
Yes, sir.
I take it you are the private's father?
I am, sir. Thomas Doss.
Then, as a former military man, you know there are laws here.
Sir, I know the law, and I know my son is protected by those laws. They're framed in our Constitution. And I believe in them as he does. They're why I went and fought to protect them. At least that is what I thought I was doing, because if it wasn't for that, then I have no idea what the hell I was doing there, sir.
Thank you, Corporal Doss. Let me have the letter. You must go. The defendant's rights as a conscientious objector are protected by an act of Congress, and he cannot be compelled to waive those rights. That includes, in this case, he's disobeying orders to bear arms. Signed, Brigadier General Musgrove, War Services Commander, Washington, D.C. Colonel?
I withdraw the charges, sir.
Then this case is dismissed. Private Doss, you are free to run into the hellfire of battle without a single weapon to protect yourself. You may resume your duties and begin training as a combat medic.